Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this class we will see the gross anatomy of the pancreas, mainly the relations of the pancreas. We have covered the gross anatomy of the pancreas in the abdomen playlist in very detail. So you go through that playlist, abdomen playlist, and see the pancreas. In this mainly we will see the relations of the pancreas as it is mainly practical oriented topic. Those who have not subscribed to the channel, do subscribe now. Keep watching the videos. Now we will see the pancreas. Pancreas is a soft lobulated gland, lies behind the stomach, separated by the cavity of lesser sac. It occupies the posterior part of epigastrium. So it is behind the stomach, occupying the posterior part of epigastrium and left hypochondrium. It resembles a retard shaped flask, the bowl of the retard resembling the head of pancreas. Presenting parts of the pancreas from right to left, the pancreas presents head, neck, body and tail. We will see the parts one by one. The head is the enlarged right extremity of the pancreas, which is contained within the C-shaped curve of duodenum. It is flattened from before backwards. The head presents two surfaces, anterior and posterior, four borders, upper, lower, right and left, and one process known as uncinate process. We will see the relations of the head of the pancreas. So this is the anterior surface of the pancreas. It is related, upper part is related to transverse colon, you should remember. So the second part of duodenum, head of pancreas, and fourth part of duodenum, you should imagine one colon running in front of all these three structures, that is the transverse colon. Lower part is related with the coils of jejunum. In front of uncinate process, superior mesenteric vessels. Posterior surface is directed backwards, non-peritoneal. So it is related, head of the pancreas, posterior surface, what it is related, you can see clearly, inferior vena cava and both renal veins. And also the bile duct. So that is also the relation, posterior surface of the head of the pancreas. Separated by the inferior vena cava, behind the inferior vena cava, the following structures, that is not so important. The structures are right sympathetic trunk, right psoas major. Mainly you should remember the relations behind this inferior vena cava and bile duct, posterior surface of the body of the pancreas. Upper border, it is overlapped by the first part of duodenum. Rest of the borders overlap the second, third and fourth parts of the duodenum. Uncinate process, it is a triangular projection which arises from the lower and left part of the head. In front of the uncinate process, superior mesenteric vessels. Behind the uncinate process, if you see, abdominal aorta. Neck connects the body and the head and the body of the pancreas. Neck presents anterior surface covered with peritoneum of lesser sac related with the pyloric end of the stomach. Posterior surface is the formation of portal vein. Portal vein formed by the, so you can nicely see the behind the neck of the pancreas, portal vein is formed by the union of splenic vein and the superior mesenteric veins. Now we will see the body. Now you are able to see the body. Body presents, it is prismoid in appearance, triangular on cross sections, extends from the front of the aorta to the front of the left kidney. Body presents three surfaces, anterior, that is antero-superior, inferior, antero-inferior, and posterior surface. Three borders, anterior border, superior border, and inferior border. So anterior surface, you can see, you have to see the anterior surface or the superior surface, antero-superior surface. It is related to, You can nicely see it is related to the postero inferior surface of the stomach separated by the lesser sac. Inferior surface is related with the coils of the inferior surface is related with the coils of the jejunum. So now we will see the posterior surface. Posterior surface is related to so many structures. You can see abdominal aorta with the origin of the superior mesenteric artery, left crest of the diaphragm, left psoas major, left suprarenal gland, left suprarenal gland, left kidney, left renal vessels and pelvis of the left ureter, left suprarenal and left gonadal veins. All these mentioned structures are separated from the pancreas by the, you can see what the vein running behind the body of pancreas is the splenic vein. So all these structures are separated from the body of pancreas by the splenic vein. Now the upper border close to the right end, it presents a conical projection known as tuberomandibular. Celiac trunk is related above the tuber. So and rest of the border on the left side of the tuberomandibular you can see. So celiac trunk you can see above the tuber. Rest of the border above that upper border you can see one artery running over the upper border, that is the tortuous splenic artery. Then anterior border separates the superior and the inferior surfaces, which gives attachment to the root of transverse mesocolon. Inferior border, that is the superior mesenteric vessels at the right end of the border. If you see the tail of the pancreas, it is a narrow left end of the gland, passes between the layers of the leno-renal ligament. Tail is the most mobile part of the gland, lies at a higher level than the head. In front, stomach separated by the lesser sac. Behind, spleen and splenic vessels. Below, left colic flexure. So in this class, we have seen mainly the relations of the pancreas, relations of the presenting parts of the pancreas. It is also a slightly difficult topic unless you understand and see the relations clearly. So I have tried to explain mainly the relations of the pancreas in this video. The remaining details of the pancreas like blood supply, ducts of the pancreas, you can see in the playlist, abdomen playlist, gross anatomy of the pancreas. Those who have not subscribed to the channel, do subscribe now. Keep watching the videos. Please press the like button and share button of the video if you like. We will see the next abdominal viscera in the next video. Thank you.